Hey everyone, I'm Sid Unnithan, a program manager for the Python AI workload PM team in DevDiv here at Microsoft. And today I'm going to be talking to you about how we can enhance the developer experience in VS Code using the Azure Machine Learning extension. So let's get started. So I'm in VS Code right now, and I see a couple of things. This is just the sample project I have open. And for context, the thing that I'm trying to build today is a wine classifier. So I have a training script, which includes all of the logic around the actual model training itself. I have a requirements file, which includes dependencies related to my training. I have a conda dependency description file, which contains the Python version that I want to be using, pip dependencies and conda dependencies. And then finally, a scoring script, which includes the logic for deploying and serving this model in production. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to navigate to the Azure tab on the left-hand side. I have the Azure Machine Learning extension installed already. When I click on the Azure tab, I actually see this machine learning pane and a list of all of my subscriptions that are tied to my Azure account. If I drop down on the subscription, I can actually see a list of workspaces that are associated with that subscription. So for all of you that are unfamiliar with what an AML or Azure Machine Learning workspace is, the best way to think about it is that it is a top-level resource that contains all of the assets and artifacts that you manage through the AML service. So if you're a new user with no existing workspaces, the AML extension actually provides you with a very easy way to create a workspace directly from within VS Code. So if I click on this Create Workspace icon, I actually am just prompted for a name. So in this case, I'm going to say test workspace. I'm then going to choose a subscription that I want to create the workspace in, the resource group that I want to tie the workspace to. In this case, I have a pre-existing resource group in the West US2 region that I want to use. And then finally, I choose a workspace SKU. So the easiest way to think about a SKU is just the set of features and tools that are available for you to use as part of the workspace. In this case, I might just choose a basic one. More information about the SKUs can actually be found on the Azure ML pricing page. So I'm not actually going to create a workspace, the reason being that it does take some time for that to happen. But what I will do is I'll actually just show you an existing workspace that I have. So if I drop down on this workspace node, I actually see a set of assets and resources that are associated with the AML service from within the extension. The first one I'll focus on is experiments. So let's go through the process of actually creating an experiment by just right-clicking on that node and clicking this Create Experiment context menu option. So when I click Create Experiment, the only thing I'm prompted for here is an experiment name. For now, I might just call this a test experiment. I might also want to see what other experiments I have before I give this a name. So I can just escape here and drop down this experiments node to see, oh, I already have a wine classifier experiment, so why not just create a second version of that? So I'm creating wine classifier. I'll call it wine classifier 2. And then what the system is doing is that it's creating the experiment for me. And as you can see, the tree is automatically updated to reflect that. So now that I've defined an experiment, the next thing that I might want to do is create a compute target upon which this experiment should run. So I can do that actually very easily from the extension by just right-clicking on this compute node and hitting create compute. I can then choose a compute type. So in this case, I want to use an AML compute. And now here I'm prompted to input a VM size. So there are a couple of ways I can do this. I can just scroll through the list to find one that I think is most appropriate for this experiment. If I know the name of the VM size that I'm looking for, I can actually just search for it directly with this input box. And then the last thing is, you know, if I know the specs of the VM size, then I can also just search for it directly through this input box. So in this case, you know what, I might want to just find one that is of a GPU type. And so then I can choose this NC6 VM size. Because I know that the size of experiment is fairly small, I'm just going to choose a simple D3 V2 VM size. And then finally, I'm prompted for a compute name, so I'll just call it my D3 compute. And so what I'm shown at the very end is a JSON file with a set of properties associated with my compute. I can read through these properties, validate that they are correct, and then just save and continue. And so now what the system will do is that it will create the compute, and it'll actually show this compute being created from directly within the tree. Okay, great. So you can see that my compute has been created. So now the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm actually going to run this experiment against my newly created compute target. So there are a couple of different ways I can do that. Let me show you one of the ways. I can actually right click on this on my training script, and I can run this as an experiment in Azure. Once I click on this command, the first thing that I'm prompted for is a subscription. So I want to run in the current subscription that I have. I can then input the workspace. So in this case, it's just the PyCon one that I had from earlier. And now I want to run it against that newly created experiment that was done so a while ago. I can choose an existing compute. So you might think that, you know, I can use the D3 compute that I just created. However, I might also realize that I want to create a new compute at this point instead of using the ones that are given to me. And so when I click create new compute, I'm actually, instead of going through the compute creation steps, just led to the next step in this workflow, which is choosing an environment. In this case, I don't want to use an existing one that Azure ML provides. I might want to create a new one. And I might want to do so using a requirements file. So I can choose this pip requirements file option, use the file that I have as part of my local project, and then finally get led to this JSON in which I see a couple of things. The first thing is the workspace in which I'm running this experiment, the experiment name itself, the environment definition, which you'll see actually has dependencies that correspond directly to the requirements file that I had earlier. And then the last thing is the compute that's going to be created. So in this case, you know, I might want to actually choose a different VM size than the one that's been auto-populated for me. And I can do so by hitting control space and choosing a VM input option similar to what I showed earlier. So in this case, I want a GPU compute type. I can choose this NC6. And then let me just rename this to GPU comp. So finally, all of these properties look good to me, and I can just submit the experiment. And now what the service is doing is that it is submitting the experiment for me. You'll see that as part of the experiment submission process, the extension is actually creating the compute. And then once the compute is created, it can then create the environment, the run configuration for that compute, and then submit the experiment. And so we'll just give it a little bit of time for the compute to be created. That was pretty quick. So you'll see this GPU comp here. And then you'll see that I have a run that's starting here automatically. So this is directly reflected in the tree, and I can see the current status of that run. If I drop down on this run, I can also see logs and outputs. In this case, I would imagine that for logs, I actually have these Azure ML logs, which shows me this image build log. And if I double click on that, I can actually stream those logs from directly within the editor. And so what's great about this is that the extension provides you with a really nice way of streaming your logs as they're being written to while the status or state of your experiment run is changing. So now that I've shown you log streaming, let me show you another really neat thing that you can do through the extension. So if I look at a completed experiment, I can actually see this run, which says that it's completed, look at the log files as I did earlier, except in this case, I might want to look at one that has already been written to fully. So if I double click on this driver log, I have the driver log outputted directly in output console here. And looking at this classification report, I'm happy about what my training run has done. And so what I want to do is I might want to then download the outputs that were produced as part of the training run. So I can do so by just navigating to the outputs folder of this run, and then seeing this pickle file and just downloading this output directly. And then the system tells me that it successfully downloaded the outputs. So now what I can do with the outputs that I have downloaded is actually I can then just register a model. And so I can say, okay, you know, I want to register this new wine classification model, and I can choose a model file, that model file being the outputs that I just downloaded, and then I can save and continue. I'm not going to do that right now, but what I will show you is that for a model that I have registered, I can actually just easily right-click on that model and hit deploy service from that registered model to then deploy it as an endpoint. So just to give you an overview of what we saw today, I walked you through creating a workspace, defining an experiment, and defining a compute, all from within VS Code through the AML extension. I also showed you how it was really easy for you to run an experiment with the AML service and stream logs for your running experiment, as well as download model outputs. The last thing that I showed was from a downloaded model output. It's very easy for you to register a model and then deploy it as an endpoint. So I'd strongly encourage you to use the extension, whether you're an existing AML user or a new one. And please feel free to provide us with feedback, either through our survey channel or by just contacting me directly. I'd be happy to talk to you about how we can improve your tooling experience with this extension. Thank you.